How are we doing, Robust family? And look, welcome. I know you're going to enjoy the episode coming up, and we have a lot more stuff on this channel. But before we engage on the new show, can I ask you to do me a small favor? Just robustly smash that subscribe and like button. It helps us a lot, and it makes sure that you do not miss a robust breakfast show beat. All right, enjoy. Good morning, guys. It's that time. This is your breakfast show. We're here with Vim Gusto, determination side of our heart. And if you are with us from our starting time of 8 o'clock, we're here every morning, weekdays, Monday to Friday, with that breakfast show, Vim. And I'm excited, and I just can't hide it. Why? Because it's Wednesday, and it's all about wellness. And I'm telling you, the way we're rolling today in the cat cam over there in the corner, we've got the one and only Kathleen and the table of justice. Oh, yes. It's fortified and full today because we're bringing the wellness, goodness in this morning. And I want to say to my left this morning, the one who helps me to work on my wardrobe to be more colorful, this is the one and only Mama Sonia. Good morning to you, Mama Sonia.
Morning, breakfast family. May love the whole of Huno. I'm blessed the whole of Huno.
Drop it like it's hot. Beside Mama Sonia, the man with the cap, the man who never stays still. I'm telling you, if he could, it has to be done because he is real. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you, warrior?
Oh, I'm very good after that.
That's it. Yeah. Over to my right side of the table of justice this morning. Oh, I'm going to feel it right now. Over to the far side, the lady, she drops bars and she doesn't go far because she's staying here with us in the studio. It's the one and only Chanel. Good morning, Chanel. Good morning. Oh, God. I'm beside her in the red corner, the lady who always has that spark. And you know you can never miss her. It's the Miss Motivator, the one and only Deborah. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Yes. And if you're wondering who is this lovely lady up in green, matching me with that kind of sheen, it's my niece, the one and only. It has to be. Oh, no.
How are you?
It's the theme song he loves to hate.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Give me K-pop, man. Just why, Justin? This is a fit. As much as I love my niece, this all comes in the package. I want to give a round of applause for my niece, the one only Tatiana. Yes. All right, let's shift it now, Kat. Please, I beg you.
Old school K-pop.
She's too happy.
I'm just enjoying it.
She's too happy.
Lovely.
Why is it these things that make you happy?
Yeah, Kat? I need that break because my daughter's the same way.
Is it?
I thought I got away from it and now I'm hearing it again. Yeah.
You see this generation. Yeah. Oh gosh, okay, we're going to share it. Okay, so look, guys, it's coming down and I just want to say a huge good morning to our listeners and Pedro over there. We asked a question before the timeout, before I forget. We asked a question and we asked you to guess this image, which is our theme for today. Have a look at this on the screen now, guys. What do you all think is our theme for today? If everyone, I'll give a count of three. One, two, three, and you think it's
lemon.
Lemon.
Of course you'd say that. Okay, yes, all right. And everybody here says lemon. Why do you say lemon, guys?
Because the face, the sour face and the yellow.
The sour face and the yellow.
I thought it would be lime because the green grass at the back and then...
Okay.
Yeah, and the baby's facial expression.
Okay, you changing things up.
Yeah.
How is it? You going into the background as well. Yeah. Well, me Julie said lemon. Rebecca in Zambia said lemon. We also, Ashipala in Namibia said lemon. It seems like everybody will just agreed lemon. You were right, it's lemon. And today our theme is going to be lemon. We're going to be looking at the health benefits of lemon. Obviously, a lot of people know all about lemon, right? Mama Son, you know about lemon, right?
Yeah, mom, I love it.
You love it?
Yeah, man.
Do you work a lot with it?
Me drink it a lot.
Serious thing?
Yeah, man.
But you know that people love lemonade, they just pour on the sugar. Like my wife, she said, oh, we're going to be healthier now, we'll do lemonade. And she put the lemon and like, then comes the white sugar.
Ooh.
And I'm like...
Honey.
right, yeah. Sorry? Just mix them, you know. Yeah. Give it that extra vim, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and so I don't know what to make of that. I just don't know what to make of it, but it tastes good.
I can relate to her if it was brown sugar.
Brown sugar.
Yeah.
Well, Yeah, stages, guys, stages. All right, so look, we are going to be talking about lemon today. And good morning to you, Jessica. We've got here a clip I want you guys to look at. My first clip, because you know I like to to show a lot of social shocks, all right? And just to give a bit of an idea, when we think about lemon, all right, we saw that picture in a moment. We might have a facial expression like the one you're about to see when we think about lemon, which is just coming up, number one. Yep. To the side. That's it. All right, so sometimes we think about lemon, you consider the idea of lemon, you have this kind of outcome. Check this out.
Let's see. Sure.
Is that, okay, let me give it a try. Come on in.
Okay.
Enough. It's not having it. Come on, let's try. Okay, looks hopeful. Okay, so feels different about lime. Love it or hate it, you know what I mean? That's how it goes down. And oh wow. And my son Ezekiel, he's the same way. He loves sour stuff. I don't know what it is, but Ezekiel loves, he will take a lemon, he'll eat it like it's an apple. It's strange. It's just his taste palette, because everybody's very different. So obviously when we think about lemon, we think about the flavor, we think about the taste. That's the first thing that comes to mind. However, did you know that it actually has a whole host of health benefits, right? But as well as the flavor, do you know that there was actually a trend with lemons? There was actually a trend with lemon. People using lemons to charge up their mobile phone.
What?
Yeah, guys. Yeah, it's more than just health. It can actually be used to charge up your mobile phone. What do you think of that, my niece?
That's weird. And how?
What?
How?
You want to see how?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll show you guys. Oh, everyone's eyes are perked up now. Yeah, yeah. Do I need to buy batteries again? Let's have a look at this, guys. Lemons.
Okay, let's check out this life hack with a phone and charger. I need 2 batteries, lemon, charger, of course, phone. I have everything and I can do it. What do you think? Is this life hack real or not? Are you ready? Okay.
No.
This life hack doesn't really work.
Oh gosh, it doesn't work.
Do you know what it's giving? It's giving 5-minute hacks. I don't know if you've seen those videos. Trum. And like they say, you can like cut a piece of a leaf and then somehow your phone will get battery, like silly stuff like that.
Yeah, and you know, if you do take a lemon, you could put like copper and another metal in it and it will give light. You'll actually get, it'll charge a small little, you'll give a bit of light. But as for mobile phones, I think we're a bit beyond that.
Yeah.
But lemons are in the limelight, like for quite a few reasons, you know? Sorry?
Lemons in the limelight.
I see.
It is what it is. All right. Well, guess what? It has some health benefits. So just have a look at this. So we got some slides here. All right. Actually, just show the beautiful lemon. I mean, look how refreshing these are. We've got some pictures of lemons. Yeah, look at that. Beautiful, right? You see that? You already feel refreshed, right? Look at that. Oh, my goodness. Chanel, is it hitting you?
This is something I'm already kind of doing already.
Okay.
But what I do is I mix lemon, lime, ginger, cucumber, mint leaves.
Hey.
I normally soak it overnight, drink it the next day.
Yes.
So, yeah, that's my lifestyle, really.
Hey, yeah. Okay. What about you, Will? A lemon. Lemon, your thoughts on lemon?
I'm not on the same level, but where I quite like lemon in water as well, but okay. I love lime in water. I'm a much bigger fan of lime, to be honest with you. So for me, lemon is like the second cousin that I don't really mind.
Because even that baby video, what is it between lime and lemon?
I think it's tastier with lime.
Lime sweeter.
Say again?
Lime sweeter.
Yeah.
To me. And Will. And others.
Is it?
It is.
Is it?
It's very nice.
Yeah.
Whenever I'm sick, that's my go-to. Yeah.
With hot water.
Yeah.
Actually, when I'm sick, I still stick with lemon, but maybe that's I think it's out of ignorance for me.
Okay. Yeah. Interesting, Idaje. Well, I mean, great thing. They're both of the same family. And to be honest with you, it actually has quite a few benefits, actually. So, for example, we've got this blue one here, speaking about the benefits. And just talking about the water, it helps keep you hydrated, which we know already. Helps to reduce blood pressure. Okay, so it says it may help reduce, helps with weight loss. All right. Has antioxidants to boost the immunity. We want to boost our immune system. That's what Will was talking about just now. Prevents kidney stones. We have a friend who had kidney stones, isn't it, Kat?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we have a friend that had kids. So they need to get some lemon in their diet. So simple. And aids in digestion, all right, amongst other things. So we actually have a lady here who's really excited about it. And she's actually talking about some of the health benefits. And I think she can drop it nicer than I could. Check this out, guys. She's excited. Very excited.
Drinking lemon water first thing in the morning can have a huge impact
on your health.
And here's why. It keeps you hydrated. Most of us don't drink enough water. The potassium in lemon water hydrates your body. If your urine is dark, you're not drinking enough water. When you're drinking enough water, your urine is clear. Yeah. The vitamin C in lemon water can boost your immune system. The flavonoids in lemon can help fight disease. Ooh. It aids in digestion. It improves your skin. It supports weight loss. It freshens your breath, it reduces inflammation, and it gives you a boost of energy. You know, many people buy expensive alkaline water because it has great health benefits. However, drinking a glass of water with lemon is cheaper, yet still effective. Once digested and metabolized, the lemon water will have an alkalizing effect.
Wow, awesome. I mean, like, I think, Deborah, you're already on that train already. Your thoughts, Mama Levi?
Lemon is used. I mean, I do sometimes drink it with water before, because I've been told that if you drink lemon water, you cut half a lemon, squeeze it in, half a glass of like warm water and half a glass, drink it down before you eat anything, give yourself half an hour. It's supposed to cleanse you.
Okay.
Yeah, so every so often I do it. Not every day, but every so often.
Okay, I think the idea, you two share the mic. I think that maybe we should, I think it's something that we should do every day. And what do you think, Mama Sonia?
Well, I use the lemon every day, but I use it in green tea.
Green tea.
Yeah, just make the green tea. I put the lemon in, and after drinking it, many am the lemon to the skin and everything. Yeah.
You don't even play, so nothing goes to waste.
No.
All right. So here's something quite interesting. All right. So we're going in. We're taking off. All right. But we have to be also very careful. Okay. Because as well as there's some good, there's also some negatives. So you can't overdo anything, right? There's some people that take lemon, they use it for their skin, they use it for all kinds of different things. And so there's actually a lady who actually kind of warns about lemon juice being a bit harmful, 2B or not 2B. That is the question. So I think, listen, I know we're getting excited about the lemon water, and this is a subject that probably most people have an idea about. But what my objective here is that for us to consider making it part of our morning routine. Because our body needs to be more alkaline, right? Yeah. But sometimes we can be a bit too radical. So just a few warnings here, just before we go further in, of what this lady has to say. Check this out.
Is lemon juice good for your skin? Well, it depends on how you're using it. If you're squeezing lemon juice into your water, big thumbs up. It's a good source of vitamin C.
We need that.
Vitamin C is required by your skin in order to synthesize collagen. But if you're squeezing lemon juice into a DIY recipe that you're applying directly to your skin, hard pass, guys. That can increase your risk for sun sensitivity, hyperpigmentation, and damage your skin barrier.
So, Tats, you say, as soon as she mentioned about these concoctions, you were like, really? Put the mic towards you. You can't speak in the mic.
As an avid skincare person, I wouldn't put lemon on my skin. That's crazy. And I think it's important before you like see and talk, do these things you see on TikTok, like these DIY things, know your skin type. Because I know I have quite sensitive skin and I have combination skin, so there's no way I'm putting lemon on my face to brighten my skin. But if you want to, I'd say use turmeric and like Greek yogurt and mix and concoction there.
You spend too much time online. this generation.
It's reducing. Trust me.
Yeah. Father of light. This generation will. I mean, you take like you know all these things on online hacks and all that. But you know what's interesting? We are in summertime. Yes. Right, it's summertime, and the reason why the subject of lemon is okay, South Africa. I'm sorry, I know you guys in winter, and it looks quite brutal over there. Do you have the video of Nosifo in South Africa? I know it's quite brutal over there, and maybe me speaking about lemon in terms of like where I'm gonna go now, you guys are probably like, we'll have to wait, right? But it's not easy because obviously we're here, we're enjoying summer. Somewhat, but over in South Africa, this one's just going out to you because Nosifo was kind enough to share this with us. This is what they're dealing with. Check this out.
So this is how the sky is like today. It's very cold. It's cloudy. Don't mind my chickens. My daddy has chickens here,
So yeah, so Nosifo's wearing a thick jumper and a thick jacket, and I never thought I would see behold such an event happening in South Africa. But lemons are good, vitamin C, yeah. Good for your immune system. So whether it's sunny or hot, it's good. But here's a nice tip in case it is hot. Check this out. Something that I never thought of, but it actually sounds like a brilliant, brilliant, brilliant idea. The ice cubes. Yeah, 2C. Check this out, guys, you're gonna love this.
If you guys have extra lemons laying around your house or you have lemons that are gonna go bad, I have the best hack for you guys. I take my lemons, I squeeze them into an ice tray, freeze them into ice cubes, and put them in my water. It's the absolute best hack that changed my life to not waste.
Now, Charlene, Chanel, that's gonna be refreshing, right?
Yeah, definitely. I was thinking to myself, oh, I never thought you could do that. So receive that idea and suggestion. That's something I'm definitely going to practice.
What do you think, guys?
Yeah.
Get it? Put the lemon thing because we want ice cubes. We want a refreshing drink. Yeah. So how much that, you know, and we've got a very interesting question. Kat, I'm coming to you in a second.
I just realized an epiphany.
Tell me, Kat.
You three are matching. Right, green.
Yeah.
Green tea.
Me and Deborah's matching.
Okay, and these two have got blue, except he's got a dark. Amazing things happening.
Wow.
Mama Sonia inspires me. I almost came with dark colors today, but I thought Mama Sonia's revelation, and I went back and pulled a t-shirt. No, seriously, it is like that with my life. Okay, we got a comment here. We got Ronika in Finsbury Park saying, "Morning, we're connected." Janet's with us, guys. The one and only Janet. Ronika says, "Can you not just drink Twinings, lemon and ginger?"
It's the same.
It's a tea. It's not. The more you process something.
Yeah.
Sorry, say that again.
The more you have something, the more your body gets used to it.
So. Yeah. But also, I think the thing about Twinings, obviously, it's dry tea, which I think is good. But if you can get a lemon, actual lemon, you know, as more natural as you go, the better, right? Because the more we start to process into something, it loses its value, etc., etc. So if you, and lemons are easy to get hold of, right? Exactly. And just a little sprinkle of that thing just in it, and just
You can even make your own ginger as well, isn't it?
You can make your own ginger.
Yeah.
But if, for example, you have them and they're in your house and you want to make a quick tea, why not?
Yeah.
Why not? But if you can, as natural as you can do it, the better. I remember we have our nutritionists come in and they were just telling us, look, the less you process something, the better it is for us.
Exactly.
The better. The more it looks like how it was made, the better.
The better.
Right? No fish fingers and no chips and McFlurry.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
We passed that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You passed through that phase.
Yeah,
we're not doing that.
Over the hill.
Okay.
You know?
Good. I'm happy. I knew we'd get there eventually. We have Janet saying, I love lemon as a dressing with olive oil, black pepper, and a bit of salt.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Oh, for salad dressing.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. That is a salad dressing. Yeah. I never thought that. So, such a simple concoction. Mm-hmm. Right? But that'd be so good, so tasty. Imagine you had a piece of salmon and you did that with it.
Yeah. I'm hungry now.
Me too, Kat. We're at that part of the show. Me Julie says, I'm going to the lemon ice. I'm going to do the lemon ice cube. Fantastic idea. But here's something quite interesting to see. You know, we were talking about the lemon. You guys have a conversation. You seem to like, you guys all met up before and colluded against me. We are looking at lemon and lime today, but you all said that you like lime. But there is an interesting difference between them. Check this video out.
Overripe lime, just a lemon? I did a little digging, and the answer, it's deeper than you think. Here's what big lime doesn't want you to know. First of all, grocery store limes are underripe. USDA regulations say that a US number one lime, which is the best one, has to be green. And farmers often harvest limes with machines, so they're not picking them when they're perfectly ripe. Check it out, underripe lime, actually ripe lime. And they're actually really good. So here's the green lime, and here's the ripe lime. Look how much juice is in this. It is less acidic and more sweet. But how does it compare to a lemon? The color is definitely different. It's more yellow on the lemon. A lemon is way, way more tart. So an overripe lime, that's just a lime. A lime's an underripe lime, and a lemon, that's something different altogether.
Okay, so same family, but they are two different things. I think I'm going to give a bit more love to lime now with this conversation that we've had. I'm going to give them a bit more love. I think I will. All right, guys. So look, another great thing. We're going to go for a timeout in just a second because we still got our Who Wants to Be a Millionaire morning coffee question trivia coming up very shortly. All right, in just a moment. But in the meantime, I just want to share with you something else that was said before about the lemon. And it spoke about detoxing our body, detoxing our liver. And I think this is a huge thing that people don't look at. I'm actually going to get a naturopath to come in and speak about the liver on the show. Because it's something that's so important, but we don't give much value to it. Kat, I've got 1B here talking about fatty liver some symptoms. And lemon is very, very good to actually help to detoxify liver. Why? Because of these reasons. Check this out.
Here are 10 indications of fatty liver disease. Scientists believe that between 80 and 100 million Americans have fatty liver disease. This disease happens when the body cannot adequately metabolize excessive fat. The fat cells are stored in the liver, causing it to enlarge and accumulate an abundance of triglycerides. Frequently, fatty liver is not bad enough to induce liver failure, but this organ has the ability to renew itself. Amazing. If you consume a healthy diet and take precautionary actions, you can undo the harm. Nevertheless, how can you tell whether your liver is in trouble? The medical term for fatty liver is hepatic steatosis. It occurs when fat accumulates in the liver. The liver is the body's second largest organ. It aids in the digestion of meals and liquids and removes toxic elements from the blood. If anything is wrong, your body will let you know. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, comment, and subscribe.
Beautiful. All right. So, interesting, right?
Yep.
I mean, we don't really know much about the liver, but the fact that it's there. But just to give you an idea, and the main theme is lemon today, but just talking about the liver. What are you smiling at that, bro?
No, I'm just like concerned about my own liver. I've even been like doing anything bad. It's just like whenever I see videos like that, I just become way more conscious of my own thing.
So, I mean, what does the liver do? And we're going to have a program just on the liver, but in passing, because we're talking about lemon, it's detoxification, all right? So, so basically, liver helps detoxify our body and also bile production as well. And obviously, these things, lemon actually helps with us, helps to clean our liver so it can keep functioning normally. Also, inflammation reduction. So, for example, flavonoids in lemon have anti-inflammatory properties that can help reduce inflammation in the liver. Oxidative stress protection. Do you know what I mean? So the liver does so much to take care, manage, help our body. The liver even rejuvenates. It literally rejuvenates itself. They do. I learned that they do liver surgery, right? And they just do part of the liver, and before you know it, after they sealed it up, the liver starts fixing itself, and it regenerates. I mean, how crazy is that? Piccolo in Dragon Ball Z does that with his arm all the time. They chop off his arm and his arm just grows right back again. He's strong.
Yes.
But that's how our liver works, right? But check this out. But how do we destroy our liver? Obviously, with our people who drink excessive alcohol, poor diet, obesity, drug abuse, in terms of even medication as well that we can take, and viral infection. So that can harm it. But drinking lemon helps to support our liver, you know? So guys, we're going to be going more into that today, but have these things in mind. Think about your liver. even ask your doctor about how your liver's doing, because we're all in a world where we eat a lot of junk, a lot of oxidation, a lot of stuff, and you know, our liver could be struggling, right? Ask about that. But also, we have a simple remedy that helps us and put things in our favor, which is the wonderful beginning of L, lemon and lime. All right, so we're going to go more into it today, and we're going to show you some nice desserts that you can actually make with the lemon as well. Who likes desserts?
I do.
Yeah, I can't promise they're going to be healthy though. What are you doing that face for? Why are you doing that face for? Why are you doing that face for? I said dessert. Like, you don't like dessert.
Like sweet things.
You only McFlurries.
We've passed the hill.
But you got off dessert.
I like dessert, but I'm trying to cut it out because I have a sweet tooth. That's the problem.
Well done.
So you know.
You're done well. Yeah. And unfortunately, I can't promise that these desserts are going to be healthy. Just saying. Some people are like, ooh, now he's talking. At first it was like, yeah. But anyway, we're going to go into it now. Don't go anywhere. Let's wake everybody else up. We're going to make some winners today when we come back from the timeout with our Who Wants to Be Millionaire Star Morning Coffee question. We're going to see which country, which continent, which town is going to walk away with it today. And we're just cruising down here, and it's all about health and wellness. How are you enjoying it so far, Mama Sonia? How are you enjoying the day, the morning so far with us?
Me, I enjoy it 1,000%.
Yeah.
You know me love coming up on Wednesday, innit?
Ah, Mama Sonia, you know you're awesome.
And guess what? Me drink me hokra water this morning.
Serious thing!
Yeah.
Hey!
Oh, that reminds us.
Yes, that is a reminder. Last week we did a program on okra. I know your face turned because you didn't watch the show. Now, those of you who were tuned with us, you left giving a big value to okra. We don't like it because of the slime. And we wanted to actually have the one and only Kathleen. You know, her taste palette is quite limited, and she doesn't really taste different types of food in the 20 plus years she's been on this earth. Ooh. And it's been 22 decades of life. And thankfully, due to the encouragement of the breakfast show, she tasted a patty, Jamaican patty. And yeah, cocoa bread. Yeah, it's that bad, man. It's that bad.
I can't lie, I reacted similarly.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not gonna lie.
So that is what we're dealing with here. That is a situation. And thankfully, she was brave enough after hearing about okra that she would try some bangkun okra stew, which is my favorite food in the whole world. And she was open for it. Unfortunately, I was this close. Mm. But I got confused along the way. I don't know if she prayed.
We knew this was gonna happen.
I know.
You weren't gonna bring it.
I know. I had everything set up, organized. I had someone prepare everything. I had
a conspiracy.
Yeah, yeah.
What happened? You left it.
No. But you know what we will do? Monday. Why are you looking at me like that? Monday. It's because of the music. Monday, we'll get a bangkun okra stew. Kathleen's going to be here, and it's going to be, we're going to see her reaction to it. Bangkun okra stew for Monday. Mama C, help me. Other than that, guys, we'll go for a timeout, and we'll be right back after this. Breakfast show. Life is good.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. Hey, just a quick interruption. I know you're enjoying the show, but don't forget, if you haven't already, robustly smash the like and subscribe button. Do it now! Do it now!
You're listening to Liberty Radio. Get motivated.
Okay, guys, welcome back. This is your breakfast show. I'm your host, Robert Ashitey. The table of justice is full. Just give a big wave to everybody over there. Yes, wherever you are, wherever country, continent, or planet you're on. I said planet. welcome. This is your breakfast show. We're here every morning from 8 a.m. All right, and today is a Wellness Wednesday on the show today, and we're looking at the subject of the lovely lemon. Has so many beautiful health benefits, so good for our liver, and it's just a simple thing of taking water, drizzle some lemon into there, and we're good, right? And we're going to go into our MCQ in just a moment, but before, I've obviously talked about the health side of it, but you can make some really beautiful desserts as well. right? I've got a nice clip here of a lovely dessert. It's called a lemon pusset. And it's a very easy dish that you might want to try when you just feel a bit like, you know, okay, fine. Just have a look at this.
Let's make lemon pusset. First, you're gonna take some lemons and then cut them in half lengthwise. Cut around the flesh of the lemon, then scoop out the center with a spoon. We're gonna add 2 cups of heavy cream, followed by 3/4 cup of sugar. Let this simmer for about 3 minutes or until the sugar is dissolved. Then we're gonna turn off the heat, add 2 teaspoons of vanilla and 5 tablespoons of lemon juice. We're gonna give this one final stir and we're gonna let this cool for around 10 minutes. Fill each lemon with some of the cream mixture. Now into the fridge for a couple hours so they set up. All right, let's give it a try. Ooh, that's phenomenal. You guys really have to give these a try.
My mama's son is like, I thought we're talking about health.
I'm thinking the same thing as well.
You know,
I could see myself kind of rebelling then, saying, oh, can I swap it with brown sugar?
That's right.
Can I add another sweet thing?
That's right.
When I saw the sugar, I was like, yeah, it's getting good. Yeah. The moment I saw the sugar, I went, whoa.
Yeah, I think I kind of jumped. I was like,
whoa. Okay. Yeah. I'm sure you're down with that, right? Like, it's looking good, right?
I'm not going to lie, it didn't. And I was surprised that I wasn't a fan of it.
Okay.
Yeah, because I'm not too much of a fan of like a
that
super
sour,
creamy textures actually.
Okay.
Yeah, so okay. I think I would like a yogurt, but outside of that, yeah, I'm not too big of a fan of that kind of stuff.
Okay, what about you, Manis? I mean, like, you seem to have, I don't know, confliction or
no, it's because your sound effects in my ear and the video turned all I heard. So but I think I have to agree with Will on that one. That one's not my cup of tea.
That's quite interesting. That's quite interesting, Kat, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean,
I'll try it.
You'd definitely try it. You've been really open, Kat. I like, that's awesome. You know, but you know the interesting thing is, like, to what you were saying, Chantel, you could try things like xylitol, which is like a leafy, it's sugar from leaves.
Yeah.
So it's not like cane sugar.
It's poisonous to dogs.
Okay. Oh, wow.
What,
mint
leaves?
Xylitol.
Yeah. Xylitol. Okay.
Huh?
It's in chewing gum. Yeah.
Sugar-free.
So there's different things you can do as a replacement. There's different things you could try. Maybe, you know, you could like mix in some cane sugar juice or something like that. But what I'm saying is, I think it looks quite impressive. I like the whole lemony taste of things, you know. Speaking of the lemony taste of things, we actually had a comment here from the one and only Maria Pedro in Hackney. And Maria Pedro said something very interesting. She said, concerning her joy over lemon, that it was Mary Pedro, right? Here we go. I love making my own salad dressing, lemon juice, lime juice, rock salt, coarse pepper, pure olive oil, mix it. I drizzle it practically on most foods and the kids love it. Absolutely, right? Just, I don't know what it is about lemon, but when you, like, do you do lemon... And like, sorry, tea and put like lemon in it as well.
Yeah, sometimes you can squeeze a bit.
Yeah. So Kaya, Ezekiel, they love that. They love that stuff for some reason. I don't know why. But all right, I've got one more to try and tickle your taste buds, all right? This one is number 3, Brazilian lemonade. Brazilian lemon. Mama's son is like, okay, let me see what you're going to do now.
See this one.
Check it out. Brazilian lemonade.
It's with limes though.
With limes, okay. All right, come on in.
Here's how you can make the Brazilian lemonade.
Mm.
I grab 3 washed limes, cut them into quarters, straight up, just put them right in there.
That's
now
it.
Add 3 cups of water.
You like that, mama son, yeah?
Now blend this for 30 seconds. Strain this liquid. And for even less pulp, strain twice. Place the lime water back in the blender, the handful of ice, and sweeten condensed milk.
It goes left.
Nice and cool.
It's
add
so
about
left.
Half a can. And you can always adjust the sweetness later. Add back onto the blender. Have yourself a Brazilian lemonade. Delicious.
I love that. I love that. I grew up with like condensed milk growing up, and I would steal it from the fridge. All right, who's guilty of that? Wow, Kathleen as well. Okay. Oh, Deborah, you never steal condensed milk from the fridge?
No, just use it, man.
Mama Levi, teach you. You as well, Chanel?
Me used to throw it in my hand and drink. And I haven't had condensed milk for years.
Yeah, trauma. Like when we don't touch it, like, you know what I'm saying?
I don't touch it for years.
Okay, Will, how was you feeling about that one? Brazilian lemonade.
I was going to say, yeah, I quite like condensed milk. I've not had it for a long time, though, but... Well, growing up, it's because we used to have it sporadically, so I never got used to it, to like have a liking for it. But otherwise, yeah, just all the ingredients I saw that was interesting. Even just blending it with the skin on. Yeah, that surprised me.
And that did.
And it still blended pretty well anyway. So I was like, oh, yeah, I'd definitely try that.
Yeah, Debs.
It looks nice, but I think minus some of the condensed milk, because when he poured it in, I was like,
I saw you almost jumped out of your chair.
I think, yeah, the headphones were coming off. Okay, but yeah, but other than that, looks good.
Okay, X McFlurry lover, how did you find it, my niece?
Oh. McFlurries are still good. Okay. Condensed milk reminds me of my great grandma and my grandma.
Yeah.
Putting it in her coffee in the morning. But it looked nice, but I think if I could swap out the condensed milk for another milk, I could mess with that.
Okay, so probably use almond milk or oat milk or something like that.
Listen, almond milk.
Yeah?
With a cup of tea.
I'm proud of you.
With a bit of honey in a cup of tea.
I'm proud of you.
Right.
I'm proud of
that's
you.
That's a good morning, that is.
That's a good morning.
Good morning.
That's awesome. What about you, Chanel?
I could see my... I've never ever tried it before, but I could see myself drinking it because of how creamy it looks and the fact that they add that milk to it.
Why not? I'm telling you.
I could see myself drinking it, definitely. And I could see myself drinking it slowly because of the flavour of the lemon and lime. And it's kind of refreshing. So,
this is it. This is all coming from lemon. I mean, it's there. It exists. Just take advantage. And it's cheap. I love the fact that it doesn't cost as much money to have a lemon. Right? I'm a whole thing about saving money. All right. So we have Clive. good morning, Clive. Janet says, I would and do love a lemon dessert. That's why you're Janet. Janet. And Nosifa says, I love lemon tea. Absolutely. Now, here we're going to go into it now. We're going to go and see what you know about lemon, all right? We're throwing out a few ideas. We're bringing it to the limelight as something that we can do every morning as part of our morning ritual that actually helps our liver as well as our other whole host of other health benefits that we should intentionally just have it in the morning, right? And probably some in the evening. Drizzle lemon. And some naughty desserts. But now, I want to see what else you know about lemon. Kat.
Yeah.
Are you ready to make some winners today?
Mm-hmm.
Play that track. Yes, my niece. I actually have a flex with this. Watch the hand gestures. Okay, guys, so we're going to go into this. It's our Who Wants to Be a Millionaire style morning coffee question. Mama, my son, are you okay? She's all right.
Yeah, all right, man.
So it's going to be a bit of fun to exercise our cranium early in the morning. Those of you still with us that haven't gone to work or you're listening at work. And we're going to have a bit of fun. Where if you do win, you receive one of our success summary ebooks. All right. They can be sent all over the world. Those of you, for the past 2 weeks, I haven't been sending them. I'm going to send them, all right, today. So hang in there. But we need two winners for today. And the rules are, Will, if you can give the rules.
Ooh.
Come on, dude. You have to drop it swiftly as well because of the time. Okay.
So one of the first rules, one of the most important ones, is all answers have to be on the WhatsApp line on WhatsApp.
Kat,
do we have the line available for us?
Drop it like it's hot.
Okay, so that's +44 75 79 79 6845.
So it can't be in the live chat, it has to be sent here via WhatsApp.
Right. Now, when you write your answer, there can be no deleting and resending. It will not count.
Absolutely.
And also another reason for why we put on the WhatsApp line is we need to be able to check the timestamps so that we're not using our new friends, AI, Google, and such and such.
Absolutely.
Exactly. And, to make sure that you write each answer as a 1A or 1B or 1C, don't just put the letter alone.
Or type it all out. Yeah, just put 1A, 1B, 1C, 2A, 2B, 2C. Good.
Indeed. And I'm just trying to think, what is the
I think that's
one?
It. You nailed it, mate.
You think so?
Shouldn't delete it and press it.
Oh, yeah, don't delete. Yeah, I think you covered that, isn't it? So you can't sit. So think twice before you press send. All right, because if you delete it and then try to send another answer, it won't count. So. That's like you said. So that's it. All right, guys. So that was very eloquently done. Okay. And it seems like we're going to... Tats wants to have a go at reading out the questions for us today. So let's get into this. And I'm actually curious to see if you can actually come up with a few of the answers as well. All right, Kat, you ready?
Yeah.
All right, everybody ready?
Yes.
Let's have some fun with this today, guys. Wake up your people. Last week, we had Charlie's Angels from South Africa. Candice Nosifo. And obviously Chanel, right, from South Africa. So let's see, call your people in. We're gonna get started. 1, 2, 3. Let's get this show on the road. Take it away, Kat. Tats, you're on.
Hello. Question one. What is the origin of the popular drink lemonade? Is it A, Italy, B, France, or C, Egypt?
Ooh, wow. This is interesting. What? Hey, Deborah's got a look in her eyes. So, what is the origin of the popular drink lemonade? Is it Italiano? A, is it I eat your frog's legs? B, France? Or is it C, the Egyptians? Man, you know, so it depends how old is lemonade, right?
Exactly.
That's kind of the question. So send your answers 1A, 1B, or 1C. 1A, 1B, or 1C. Let's get the show. And if you don't know, just guess. It's just a bit of fun to start your morning right.
I guess.
And you won last time, Royal Flush. That was powerful last week, by the way, Mama. Yeah, that was powerful.
Crazy.
Indeed, walnuts. You can do the walnuts. Absolutely. Number two, let's go, Kat.
Number two is Tatiana.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, question two. How can lemon water contribute to weight loss? A, by boosting metabolism. B, by suppressing appetite. Or C, by burning fat directly.
All right, guys, so it's kicking off now. Just having a look at the WhatsApp line. We've got South Africa present. Candice is present. Nosifo is present. We've almost got the Charlie's Angels again from South Africa, or God's Angels rather. We've got Nottingham present. We have Netherlands present. Hackney is present. Wow. Two from Hackney present. Oh, wow. The Joshua and Caleb vibe. And also Selena Green is present.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Write down your answers to A, to B, or to C. That is the question for you and me. Let's go to number three, Kat. Oh, sorry. Tats.
Similar. Question three. What effect do lemon and limes have on skin health? A, they can cause rashes. B, they provide hydration. Or C, they promote collagen production.
All right, guys. What effect do lemons and limes have on skin health? This is very, very interesting. All right. They can cause rashes. B, they provide hydration. Or C, they promote collagen production. I hope you've been following the show this morning. Oh, that's what we do now. All right, let's go to number four. Kat, Tats. It's also pilots. Muscle memory.
Okay. Question four. What is the pH nature of lemon and limes once metabolized in the body? A, acidic. B, neutral. Or C, alkaline.
All right.
I'm back in chemistry discussion.
Indeed. For A, for B, for C. By the way, Mijuli is present. So we have the juggernauts are here. Mijuli and Janet are both on the scene, as well as the Charlie's Angels. The only one missing is from France is Miss Evelyn. That's the only one that's missing right now. We would have the juggernauts in. Selena Green's on the same scene as well. Wow, Finsbury Park present. Let's keep it going. Number five, my niece.
Okay. Question five. What component in lemons and limes aids in preventing kidney stones? A, fiber. B, citric acid. Or C, calcium.
All right, guys. 5A for fiber. 5B for citric acid. Or 5C. So just send that to us, 5A, 5B, or 5C. Let's get this show on the road. Hackney is in full power. Seems like we have a newcomer ending 072. It's really kicking off now. And we're going to see who's going to take it away this morning. All right. So as we get ready for that, I just want to show you guys another clip, guys. I love showing you guys clips on the subject matter because it helps to illustrate what's going on in my brain. Yeah, you know.
I feel like we'll never be able to discover what's going on in your brain.
Yeah. It's one of those things. Yeah. So look, check this out, guys. Germs under a microscope, 3A. Germs under a microscope. So you know we talked about lime for our health and all that kind of stuff. how powerful is a fighting germs? Have a look at this quick clip while we start to calculate all the results. Check this out.
Today I'm going to show you lime juice versus germs under the microscope. I cut one in half and squeezed the contents into a small jar to set aside for now. First, let's take a look at the water we'll be using. It's grown a thick biofilm on the surface of the water that's carrying millions of these bacillus or rod-shaped bacteria. I added the lime juice here, and you can see that once it comes in contact with the bacteria, they stop moving almost immediately. Lime juice is around 85 to 90% water, with the rest being organic acids, sugars, vitamins, flavonoids, and some essential oils. Citric acid makes up around 4 to 5% of lime juice and is one of the main reasons that lime juice is such a strong antibacterial. All of the acids present give lime juice a pH of around 2 to 2.5, which easily damages the cell membrane and results in the death of the bacteria. There's also other compounds present in lime juice that have strong antibacterial properties like malic acid, limonene, vitamin C, and many others. You can also see that it renders these paramecium cells here completely immobilized once it comes in.
Lime juice. Lime juice. Do you know what I'm saying? This is deep, right?
It's very deep.
Right?
Cool.
It's I can imagine.
Right?
Yeah.
It's more than just flavor. It's just more than just taste. We're taking it down to a microscopic level, guys.
I can't lie. Watching that, it reminded me of a video you sent me of why I shouldn't bite my nails and all the, all the icky stuff there in the nails.
Yeah.
But
Lime juice. Lime juice. I have the same thing with Kaya biting her nails. So like lime juice, so it's good. It literally is a you know, something to help to kill germs. You know, I've got a clip here actually just to back it up with a one of the doctors here, Dr. Mandel, freebie cat, just explaining it. And this is what added benefits happen when you drink some lemon water. I mean, check it out, lemon or lime water.
And don't forget your lemon and water first thing in the morning. Many people are talking about reducing your body's acidity by eating and drinking alkaline foods. Well, you may be surprised that just taking lemon juice and putting it in water like that, that lemon juice outside the body is acidic. But when you drink this, it goes through different chemical changes in the body and it raises your body's pH. This promotes healthy cell function and structure. This creates a less environment for bacteria and viruses to thrive in your body. This lemon juice will actually increase peristalsis. It will help those enzymes to start working better first thing in the morning. It's great for your liver to help detoxify it, as well as so many other positive things. So don't forget your lemon and water first thing in the morning. Your body will love you.
Thank you.
So are we gonna start trying some new habits now?
Yeah,
because everything I learned on The Breakfast Show, I have to go away and do it. You know what I mean? And I think the whole goal that we have on The Breakfast Show on Wednesdays now is like to kind of steer our thoughts to things that we didn't really think about before. Because they're just simple things. Yes or no, Mama Sonia?
Simple, we just have to practice it.
And it makes a whole heap of difference. Imagine just that small thing, what it can do for your liver debs, for our livers.
For cleansing the liver, because people, I mean, we just take our bodies for granted, don't we? We just think that we can just eat food and it's all right as long as we've had something. But, you know, it goes to show how technical our body is, how amazing it is as well. The fact that it can actually repair itself, it can. But we still have to look after our bodies.
And what we put into our bodies, you know, is a big thing. It's our decision, right?
Yeah, I have to keep up with it, definitely, because that's something that I drink anyway. And the good thing about lemon and lime, it also stops you from getting a cold as well. So if you were to get sick and you were about to get a cold, in my case, I remember a few times where I've got a cold, and within a day it just disappears again.
That is what I do.
And it's down to the lemon and lime. Instead of running to the doctors and getting the medication and whatnot, use a lemon and lime, it'll just get rid of it instantly.
Just once again, bear in mind, we're not doctors, we're not specialists. I have nothing to do with the, you know, health industry in terms of that, but I'm just a robust presenter that likes to get information and share it with the masses. So always follow your doctor's instructions before you do anything. Anything.
Yeah.
Anything. Please. Right?
Yes.
Why are you looking at me like that, Tat?
I just like, I like the cheeky disclaimer, the little caveat of like, you know.
Guess what? Speaking about it being antibacterial, I've actually got a clip for you, right? Free ACAP. And being antibacterial, some of the benefits, you might see this, you might have a certain vibe in your house that you want to produce, and you go to the shop like you touched on earlier just a second ago, and you go and buy all these different things. Look at what you can do here to like make your house smell really nice. Check this out.
Stop throwing out those used lemon peels.
Instead, add them to a pot with some thyme, vanilla, and cloves. Ooh. Simmer and your house will smell like William Sonoma. After, reserve that liquid for a non-toxic air freshener. That's episode 83 of Scrappy Cooking, where nothing goes to waste.
Simple. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Simple.
Nice. Yeah.
Just chuck it in a thing, add some thyme, and you're done. Sorted.
Wow.
Life moves on.
It's a good idea, yeah.
Say it again. I sound like who? You? No, you sound like me.
No, you sound like me. We're not doing this on a retro show. What? You sound like
You're trying to command me now.
You're
trying to command me. You come here now. You sit down. You want to command me. Guys, we're going to go for a timeout. We've got a comment here from Candice. Candice says, just noticed I made some mistakes somewhere, I think. The questions are always tricky.
Yeah.
But that's how we learn. It's just fun. We're learning. Good morning, Jordan H. That's from Janet. Good morning, Jordan H. I hear you doing a bit of hawker stalking. That'll do. Right. How did you find the okra? We're speaking about that, Janet. We'll come back to that in a second. You see, look what you caused now. We're going to go for a timeout. Okay? We'll go for a timeout. When we come back, we'll find out the results from this morning's morning coffee question trivia and find out who is taking away today. Which country, continent, town? I'm looking forward to know. You guys feel confident today?
Mm.
Will?
Yeah. It's the wording of some of the questions.
Deborah.
Bit of a tricky one for me. Extra tricky. So I'm not... You know, I don't have high hopes.
I think I'm 50-50 as well.
Gosh. All right. All right. Let's see. Let's see. It's just some fun in the morning time. We're right back in just a moment, right after this.
Joining you on your London commute, The Breakfast Show with Robert Ashitey.
It really is that time. We're wide, fired, where it expired. Yeah, we're a bit over 10. All right, guys, this is your breakfast show, and I hope you've been enjoying the tracks. It's a Wellness Wednesday, and before the timeout, we actually looked at, the trivia, and we need to make some winners for today. But just before the trivia, you know, we was actually sharing how much of an antiseptic that lemon is, which is our theme for today, as well as the health benefits inside of our body. It's actually good for our environment. And I actually want to show you a very quick clip, Free Sea Cat, where we're talking about the power of a lemon. Something that after you've drunk it and it's done you good in the morning, you know, you might have some leftovers there that you don't want to blend. You can use it for something else. I want to show you this quick video, guys. Many times you want to get chemicals and spray it around your house, and we're hearing that's not good, and we're inhaling that, it's not even good for our liver, right? Check this out.
Oh no, don't throw away that citrus peel. Let's make an all-purpose citrus cleaner. So I'm going to take the citrus peel from lemon, limes, and oranges and make this simple all-purpose cleaner by just adding some white vinegar and letting it sit for about 2 weeks, and then it's ready. Now, citrus peel contains D-limonene, a natural solvent that breaks down oil and dirt. And when you combine it with white vinegar, which is a disinfectant, the D-limonene creates a natural cleaning agent that's great for cleaning bathtubs, sinks, appliances, stoves, and even glass. But because of the acid, it's not good for marble, stone, or some granite. All right, enjoy.
Beautiful.
Oh, my word.
Tell me. Yes, open your heart.
Because I make the lemon, lime, and ginger a lot. Yeah. And then as soon as I finish with it, I normally throw the whole peel and everything away. So I realize how much I've wasted. So now I know what to do with the leftovers.
That's what we do. That's what we do. And you're going to be feeling even more excited and you won't be able to hide it because now we're going to make some winners. I hope you are loving the lemon today.
By the way, I got a question to ask.
Oh, go ahead.
How do you feel about, you know, when people wash their meat and they add the lime to take away the bacteria?
That's more of a Caribbean thing, isn't it?
Yeah, lemon.
Yeah, that, I mean, they have the thing about taking the eye out of the egg and all that business. I don't understand it, but I can understand if it kills bacteria.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Then I can see why.
Yeah, to freshen your meat before you season it up.
If it's cold, you're doing it.
And it's good for cleaning the sink, the leftovers.
Look at that concoction that man made. It's awesome.
Yeah, it's good.
It's awesome sauces. Beautiful. All right, guys, are you ready? I hope you're appreciating the lemon now. Now I'm sure you'd be more appreciative if you win today's morning coffee question trivia. Let's get into this. Are you ready? I am. It's okay, my niece. Be strong. It's okay. Be strong. All right, we got some comment here. Oh, Robert, please warn us before Wednesday so we get stock up on these health foods. The supermarkets, the supermarkets love you. Okay, also, just as well, I bought enough lemons for the week. Absolutely, let's get started on this. So, let's go with the questions now. Kat, sorry, my niece.
How are we going to do this?
Oh, yeah, how
we... The answers.
Oh, yeah. All right, we'll do it. Let's do it the normal. Okay, go for it, yeah.
All right, so the first question of today was, where is it? What is the origin of popular drink lemonade? Was it A, Italy, B, France, or C, Egypt?
All right, now answering A, we had Maria Pedro from Hackney. By the way, Maria Pedro left me a nice comment in the WhatsApp line. She said like this, with tears, if I get less than 5, I will cry, literally.
Wow.
You know when someone's competitive?
Oh,
it's like, we're going against the world! We're going against the world, me and you. So answering A, we had M. Pedro. Mijuli answered A in Leicester. Also, Jessica in Netherlands answered A. Miss Selena Green is with us. She answered A, representing Finsbury Park. Candice answered A. What did you say, Mama Sonia? What did you think it was? You answered B. Okay, what about you, Will?
I went for A.
Will went for A. What about you, Chanel?
I went for B.
B. What about you, Debs?
A.
A. What about you, Manis?
I'm going to throw a wild card and say C.
Okay. Well, okay. Also, we had answering B. We had Clive from Hackney. Also from Hackney, yeah. Tony from Glasgow is with us. Great to have you with us. David Stavenhill said B, and so did Nosifo in South Africa. We have the Charlie's Angels here. Candice said A as well. And answering C, like you, we had Jeanette from Nottingham and also Victoria from Manchester. All right. Kat, what's the correct answer?
The correct answer is...
Is... Lemonade is believed to have originated in Egypt as early as the 12th century, where lemon juice was mixed with sugar and water. Egypt does it again. Let's go for question number two, Kat.
Question number two was, how can lemon water contribute to weight loss? Was it A, by boosting metabolism, B, by suppressing appetite, or C, by burning fat directly?
All right, so answering A, we had Maria Pedro and also Tony from Glasgow and also Victoria from Manchester answered A. Answering B, we had the one only Jeanette from Nottingham and Selena Green from Finsbury Park, both answering B. And obviously, me, Julie didn't agree with Jeanette on this one. Answering C, and Clive from Manchester answered C, and so did David from Stafford Hill and Jessica from Netherlands and Nosifo and Candice all answered C. Mama Sonia, what did you say?
Yeah.
What about you, Will?
I went for A again.
What about you, Chanel?
A.
What about you, Debs?
C.
What about you, Manis?
I'm saying C.
Why?
I remember science lessons from many, many years.
You're looking
years
at my
ago.
Sheet. That's what you're doing.
I'm not looking
those,
at your
those
sheet.
Those spectacles of yours.
I'm getting accused of cheating here, guys.
Okay, fine. Well, Kat, what's the correct answer?
The correct answer is
is
A,
Hey! This is very interesting, guys. It's kicking off. So, drinking lemon water can increase metabolic rate and support weight loss efforts. So, if you want to shed a few pounds, get some lemon in your glass. Next one, number three. Let's go.
The next question was, what effect does lemons and limes have on skin health? Is it A, they can cause rashes, B, they can provide hydration, or C, they promote collagen production?
All right, now answering A, we had Clive from Hackney, and also Victoria from Manchester, all answering A, all right? Then we had answering B, Mijuli in Leicester, and David in Stafford Hill, as well as Jessica in the Netherlands, as well as Nosifo and Candice, they both agree from South Africa, answering B. Answering C, for they promote collagen, we had Maria Pedro, also from Hackney. So if Clive didn't get it, maybe Maria will. Jeanette from Nottingham, Tony from Glasgow, and also Selena Green. What did you say, Mama Sonia?
Mrs. C.
C, Will?
I said B.
Chanel?
A.
Debs?
B.
It's okay, so well today. My niece?
I'm saying A.
A. Kat, what is the correct answer?
The correct answer is...
C. C! Yay! So well done to Maria Pedro. All right, Jeanette. So quite a few there. Jeanette and Mijuli didn't agree on that one.
But looking good.
I'm feeling it. I'm feeling it. By the way, so basically they promote collagen production. The vitamin C in lemons and limes helps to the production of collagen, a protein vital for skin elasticity. Thank you. And health. Lovely. Hey, you're trying to throw bars at me now. Let's go for question number four, Kat.
Question number four was, what is the pH nature of lemons and limes once metabolized in the body? Is it A, acidic, B, neutral, or C, alkaline?
All right, now answering A, we had Mijuli answering A. Jessica in Netherlands answered A. Answering B, we had Tony from Glasgow, as well as Candice in South Africa, one of the God's angels for this from South Africa. Answering C, we had Maria Pedro, Clive from Hackney, Janet from Nottingham, David from Stafford Hill, Victoria from Manchester, Selena Green from Finsbury Park, and Nosifo from South Africa, disagreeing with her partner in righteousness, Candice. What did you say, Mama Sonia?
Mrs. C.
Will?
I said C.
Chanel?
I said A.
Debs?
C.
Manis? A. B. Kat, what's the correct answer?
The correct answer is... C.
C. All right, guys. The way that it works is, despite their acidic taste, lemons and limes have an alkalizing effect on the body once metabolized. That was from Healthline. Debs are like, yeah, we got that one. All right, let's go for the final question, number five.
Number five was, what component in
lemons... Wait, Debs, you put C.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I put C.
That was for number four, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
C was the correct answer?
Yes.
Okay, that's fine.
Why would it...
Yeah. I was losing on. It. Yep, moving on.
What component in lemons and limes aids in preventing kidney stones? Is it A, fiber, B, citric acid, or C, calcium? Robert.
Yes, okay.
What did you do?
I'm okay. I'm all right. I've been spiritually flabbergasted. All right. So answering A for question number five, we have David from Stafford Hill. All right. He was the only one who answered A. Answering B, we had Mijuli in Leicester, you know, the one on the juggernaut. We have Clive from Hackney. Jeanette from Nottingham answered B. Tony answered B. Jessica in Netherlands answered B. Victoria answered B in Manchester. Selena answered B. Nosifa answered B. Candice answered B. Answering C, we had Maria Pedro, and she was the only one. And what did you think it was, Mama C? Mama Sonia?
B.
B. Will?
I think it's B as well.
Chanel?
I think it's a B as well.
Debs?
B.
Tats?
B.
Kat, what is the correct answer that helps him with kidney stones? Yeah.
The correct answer is B.
Oh. B. Well, done, everybody. That was absolutely awesome. So we're gonna get our responses for today. While I'm gonna announce the winners. All right. I just had a little bit of a thing there. I need to double check.
Robert.
Yeah, I just had to. All right. But check this out, guys. I've got another video to show you guys, just to look at very briefly. And maybe, for example, you love lemons, and you're thinking of going to the shop, but why don't you just plant your own? Check how easy this is, guys. I'm sure you're going to love it. Yeah.
I want the videos as well, please.
Yes, ma'am. Check that one in the middle. That's right. All right, let's go.
You grab a lime, slice it open, take out a seed, and soak it in water for 6 hours, snip off the tip of it with a knife, then peel off the outer layer of the seed, grab a pile of soil, plant the seed about a half an inch deep, loosely cover with soil, and mist the soil with water. Put a shot glass over for humidity, and boom, the seed will sprout, and then grow into a baby lime seedling. When it's 6 inches long, with a few sets of leaves, transplant it to a bigger pot, and grow a lime tree.
Bye.
Grow it outside or in your home.
We'll say bye to you.
All right, guys. Bye. So look, you can actually grow it. Bye-bye, Mama Sonia.
Bye.
Off to 10 o'clock, off to faith school. That's how we roll, universal life. All right, guys. So look, we have here our results, and just showing you that all these things that we're learning, we don't even have to pay for it, right? We can actually just grow them.
You can grow it inside of your house.
Grow it inside of your house.
Flat, for example.
Right? Imagine, think about it. Just think, if we take ourselves seriously, what we're learning seriously, there are a lot of options here. That's me. It's me, isn't it? Is it me, Kat?
That's you, definitely.
No.
It's not me. It's you.
No.
He's cheeky, though.
Yeah. All right. So, anyway, let's see the results for today. Are you ready for this, guys?
Oh, yeah.
All right. So, the results are in with one correct answer. Give me some suspense music, Kat. So, with one correct answer today, we had, I don't believe it, but I believe she's working at the same time, multitasking continuously. We had me, Julie. Well done, me, Julie.
Oh, that's crazy.
Well done.
David from Stephen Hill, Jessica from Netherlands, and Candice with one correct answer. Also, we had with one correct answer today, Chanel with one correct answer today.
Me, just two correct answers.
Okay, sorry. Let me update. Yeah. Trying a new thing every single time, every single week. Deb's got one correct answer.
No, I got two.
Two, sorry.
Well.
How dare you?
What's wrong with you today?
I'm fine.
Are you sure you checked it correctly?
Yeah, you got two. With two correct answers today, we had the one only Maria Pedro in Mark Hackney. She said if she gets less than five, she's going to start crying.
Sorry.
Tough. Right, but good attempt. Clive in Hackney as well got two, the Hackney crew. We have with two as well, we have Will here in the studios, right?
Three.
Oh,
what is he doing with
it? Come on now.
I want a recap.
We need a recap.
Don't start.
Start rebelling. We want
don't start.
Right. Where is that?
Chanel got two. Yes, Chanel, well done, Chanel. And Deb's got two. Yeah, yes. It wasn't easy.
Yeah, it wasn't.
And my niece got. Yeah.
Justice.
Yeah,
justice.
Right. Justice. Justice. Go eat a lemon.
Lemon protest.
Absolutely. With three correct answers today, we have the one and only Tony from Glasgow. Good attempt today. Well done. We have the one and only Selena Green from Finsbury Park. Well done today. We also have Nosifo, South Africa. Yeah. Oh, no, that was nice. And we also have the one and only Mama Sonia with three today.
Yay.
So did Will with three today, Will. You're turning the tables little by little, Will.
Exactly.
You're doing it, Will. With four correct answers today, because nobody got five, we have the one and only, drop on the scene for the first time, Victoria in Manchester. And guess who else got four as well today? The one and only, Janet! Well done. So there are two winners for today, Janet and Victoria in Manchester, holding down Nottingham as always. Look, guys, it's just a bit of fun.
Yeah.
But you winners today are going to receive our success summary ebooks. Our listeners keep them as trophies that they collect. So far, Janet has the most, more than any other listener around the globe. Wow. It was Janet. Me, Julie, but Janet took over.
She picked her.
And that's right. And Miss Evelyn is close behind. Yeah. She joined the breakfast show later on. So it's fun. The Success Summary eBooks are going to help you with whatever you're doing. But it's great having you all on the show today. Guys, this has been your breakfast show. We had our two winners. We do have a follow-up question that I'm going to put out there, and you can put it on the WhatsApp line. If you are on the WhatsApp broadcast, definitely just you have the number. Message us on the virtual broadcast if you want to be added. But I'm going to put it on the WhatsApp broadcast, and we'll let you know the answer if you're all correct. All right? Other than that, on Monday, we're going to have Kathleen drinking some, eating some okra stew and banku. All right. Tomorrow on the breakfast show, we're going to have Relationship Power Thursday, and it's going to be going down. Table just going to be fully going down tomorrow. Hey, God, fuck it, Amber. I'm telling you, brother. I silly will. And I just want to thank all of you and Jeanette and Victoria. Well done. Until next time, we wish you all a robust day, and let's go and eat some lemons. Until next time, ciao for now, everyone. Bye-bye. God bless you. God bless. Oh, open camera. Over this way. Yeah, yeah. Eat some lemons. Eat some lemons. Bye-bye. Eat some lemons. God bless you. Yeah. I'll put the question on the screen while it's like doing its thing. Huh? Yeah, just to put it up there for fun. Yeah, I know I've just confused you because we didn't have a tiebreaker today. Yeah. But I just thought, like, take a screenshot, message the WhatsApp line, guys. That would be cool. Yeah, we're having fun with it. Yeah, that's great. So the what happens to the aroma of lemons and lime when their zest is used? A, it diminishes. B, it... I'm just trying. B, it becomes more intense. Or C, it stays the same. Just send A, B, or C to the Breakfast Show WhatsApp line. You should know what it is by now. Until tomorrow, ciao. God bless you all. Bye.
Bye-bye.
We're done. Life is good. Okay, guys, I really hope you enjoyed that show and you actually captured that breakfast show vim. We laugh, we joke, we learn, and we equip ourselves for day-to-day life. If you want to see more, guess what? We're actually live with a live chat and a live video feed Monday to Fridays on libertyradio.co.uk from 8 a.m. in the morning. So don't miss a breakfast show beat. Like and subscribe if you haven't, and definitely connect online. And I'd like to see you there on the show. Type your name in, communicate on the morning. If you didn't already, we're also on Instagram. Check us out on Official Liberty Radio on Instagram. There's so much happening on that platform. Definitely go check it out. And I'd love to see you there. All right, have a good one.